So we have completed the major joint of this hand limb as per the syllabus. So out of these, the digit joint is remaining right now. So we all know from hip joint to the postern joint, first joint is the pelvic joint, or hip joint, stifle joint, hock joint, and next is fetlock posterior coffin joint. So in this series, we have completed the three joint, major joint, three soft joint, that is the interphalanges or joint of the digit, in which the different bones are involved for the formation of joint. So you see, this is the structure of metatarsal, and this is the first phalanx, second phalanx, and third phalanx. Okay, so this is visible, Gaurav.
Yes, sir.
So this metatarsals, or in case of the forelimb metacarpals, comes in contact with the first phalanx, and behind that there are four small bones which act as the connecting link between the metatarsal and first phalanx, that is the sesamoid bones. So for in case of the ruminant or in case of the pig, because it is cloven footed animal, there are two digits present, except in case of the monogastric animals, in case of the equines, there is a single digit. So this metatarsal comes in contact with the first phalanx. On its plantar surface, there are small bones which act as the connecting link between, known as sesamoid bones, and in between second to thirds, there is another small bones, sesamoid bones, that is known as distal sesamoid bones or navicular bones. Their number is only one. So in one digit, there are three sesamoid bone presents, two on the proximal row and one at the distal row. So how many present in the one limbs, means one forelimb, there are two pair, one pair of the forelimbs, so for one limb, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. So the total sesamoid bones present in the one limb of the forelimb, that is the 6, and both forelimb contains 12 sesamoid bones, that is located on the fetlock and coffin joint. So this is the structure of a bovine's, or we can say also a structure similar to that of the pig, and this is the structures of the horse. It is single, not a cloven-footed animals. Single digits comes at the ground, and this is the metatarsal, distal end of the metatarsal. This is the first phalanx, second phalanx, and the third phalanx. And in between this, involvement of the first phalanx, this first phalanx, proximal row, and distal row of the metatarsal forms a joint that is known as fetlock joint. And this is the postern joint, and this is the coffin joint. Means coffin joint form with the help of three bones. So, Akriti, Amit, are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
You tell me the three bones which involve in the formation of coffin joint. There are three bones involved in the formation of coffin joint. These bones are
the second phalanx, third phalanx, and navicular bone.
Can you speak again? Akriti, Amit, there are three bones involved in the formation of coffin joint. These bones are
the second phalanx, third phalanx, and navicular bone.
Wrong. This is wrong. Amresh, 2-for-1. Amresh? Are you listening to me, Amresh? Those who will not reply my questions during this class period will also consider as absent. 2-for-2, Aman Kumar.
Yes, sir.
Question is that coffin joint is formed by the formation of three bones. These bones are
third and fourth phalanx.
Third and fourth phalanx. Is the fourth phalanx present? Is the fourth phalanx present? In this previous slide, there are three phalanges. there is no in any species. जब इसकी संख्याएं तीन है तो चौथा कहां से आ गया? ऋषभ
सेकंड एंड थर्ड
ऋषभ रंजन देयर आर थ्री बोन्स ऋषभ रंजन म्यूट करेगा 264 यू इनलिस्ट द बोन्स व्हिच हेल्प इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑफिन जॉइंट हु विल आंसर प्रेरणा गौरव प्रेरणा प्रेरणा
यस सर
यू इनलिस्ट द नेम ऑफ थ्री बोन्स विच फॉर्म्स द कॉफिन जॉइंट बैट याद नहीं है साहिल राज 239
यस सर
तीन बोन का नाम बताओ जो कि कोफिन ज्वाइंट का निर्माण करता है और दिख रहा है
सर नहीं पता
फिर ये नहीं पता है ये क्या जवाब स्लाइड दिख रहा है स्लाइड इज विजिबल
यस सर
नेविगुलर बोन
ये दिख रहा है ना जी दिस इज कोफिन ज्वाइंट एंड दिस इज फॉर्मड बाय द वन नेविगुलर बोन्स दैट इज द फैलिंग्स एंड द थर्ड फैलिंग्स इसमें क्या है कि नहीं मालूम है सर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन दिस पिक्चर this is the fetlock joint, this is the postern joint, and this is the coffin joint. In coffin joint, two phalanges involve, third and second, and in between two, there is the on a small bone, that is the distal sesamoid bone, also known as navicular bone. Okay? So, we will discuss here the fetlock, postern, and coffin joint of the different species. So, first is the fetlock joint. Fetlock joint is also known as metatarso. Phalangeal articulations. Metatarso phalangeal articulation means if anybody asks to you what is fetlock joint, then answer will fetlock joint formed by the articular surface of distal extremity of metatarsals and articular surface of proximal extremity of fax phalanx along with the four sesamoid bone. So this forms the fetlock joint. So in any joint we have already discussed there are four important structures will involve or the detailed description that will be the first will type, movement, bone involvement and ligaments. So in this type means fetlock joint, metatarso phalangeal joint, type will be the hinge. Hinge means anterior and posterior lateral or medial movement we can say. Means extension and flexion. Movement will extension and flexion. We have already discussed during the standing position of any limb, those bones are located vertically, the type will be hinge. Except the some like the patella and the carpal because the small bones are involved and where the type will be gliding there. So movement is extension and flexion. Indicates it increase the angle between two bones and decrease the angle between two bones. Okay, so this is the movement and bone involvement. We have already discussed the distal extremity of the large metatarsal and proximal extremity of the first phalanx along with the some sesamoid bone and behind the proximal sesamoid bone. Okay, so bone involvement is clear, movement is clear and type is clear. Now, ligaments. There are three ligaments are involved. Capsular ligament, we have already discussed, this is common for the all joint except the temporohyoid articulations. And next is the collateral ligament and third is the sesamoidian ligament because the sesamoid bones are present which help in the attachment of these three bones. So, this is sesamoidian ligament. So, capsular ligament. First is the capsular ligament. Capsular ligament includes the joints, distal extremity of the metacarpals over the proximal end of the first phalanx. So, here the at these positions, the capsular ligament will present, which act as the connecting link between the, connecting link between the proximal part of the metatarsal, so distal part of the metatarsal and proximal part of the first phalanx. So this ligament is clear. Next is the collateral ligament. Here below the metatarsals, the word lateral and medial will not used here. Here the for the description of the surface and the structure related to this surface will considered as the axial and abaxial. Means the structure which present towards the center will consider as the axial, and the structures which away from the axis will abaxial. In above joint, hock joint and the stifle joint, the ligament was lateral collateral ligament and the medial collateral ligament. But here the ligament will be axial and abaxial. So capsular is clear. Next is axial and abaxial. You see this picture. Axial ligament will be located here and abaxial will be located here. But in the previous joint that is considered, that was considered as medial collateral ligament, and here was the lateral collateral ligament. But this is here the abaxial ligament and this one is the axial ligament. Okay, so you see here about the collateral ligament are the twin number, abaxial and axial ligament. Abaxial ligament extend from the lateral aspect of distal extremity of large metatarsal, distal extremity of large metatarsal, to the abaxial sesamoid of the proximal end along with the proximal part of the first phalanx. Means it indicates the structures. This is the lateral surface, and here below the metatarsal, this is considered as the abaxial surface. So this abaxial ligament is originates from this part, distal extremity of the metatarsal, and comes in contact with the proximal row of the sesamoid bones along with the first phalanx of its proximal part. So this is the location or position of the abaxial ligament. Just opposite to this one, this is the position of abaxial, and this will be the position of axial ligament. So axial ligament is this one, arises from the cleft of the large metatarsal bones and spread out of the cleft of the large metatarsal bone, then reaches up to the proximal part of interdigital space of the first phalanx, where the fibers blended into superior interdigital ligament. Means this word indicates regarding the axial ligament, it originates from here. This is the metatarsal and this is the sesamoid bone. So metatarsal on its the proximal part having a cleft, that is known as inter, this part having the cleft here, and this cleft or the axial side is for the origin of the ligament. This ligament is known as axial ligament. So axial ligament originates from this portion in between two interpondyle space, distal part of the metatarsal, runs vertically and reaches up to the proximal part of the fascia. So this is the position of the axial ligament, and later on this ligament is considered as the interdigital ligament because their positions is in between two digits. So this is considered from here to here interdigital ligament. So I think abaxial and axial is clear, and we have completed two ligaments. First was the capsular ligament, collateral ligament having two parts, axial and abaxial. And abaxial is comes in contact with the three bones that originates from the distal part of the metatarsal, reaches up to the abaxial sesamoid bones. Means the lateral sesamoid, there are four number of sesamoid bone. Two are in axial position and two are abaxial in position. You see here, these two considered as abaxial, this one, and this is considered as abaxial sesamoid bone, and this is considered as axial sesamoid bone. So this ligament originates from distal part of the metatarsals and runs downward in directions, comes in contact with the abaxial sesamoid bones along with the proximal part of the first phalanx. And just opposite to this one, this is the axial sesamoid bone, axial ligament, which originates from the interclept of the metatarsal distally, runs downward in direction and comes in contact with those two phalanges, and this joint, this ligament is considered as interdigital axial ligament. So I think this is clear, axial and abaxial. Okay, this axial is considered an interdigital ligament, and which is located on the superior part, upper part, we consider as the interdigital superior ligament. I think this is clear, Gaurav.
Yes, sir.
Good. So now it is time for the sesamoidian ligament. So total number of sesamoidian ligament is 11. But on the basis of their positions, there are four considered as superior, intersesamoidian, collateral, and inferior. So there are four sesamoidian bones, but their number are different. They contain the different in number. So this is considered as total number is about 11 sesamoidian ligament. Out of 11, first is superior, four in number, superior intersesamoidial, two, third is collateral, and fourth will inferior. So total are four types of the sesamoidian ligament, but total number is 11. So out of four, first is the superior ligament, superior sesamoidian ligament, and its number is 2. So what is superior sesamoidian ligament? You see this picture. Picture is visible, Gaurav? Picture is visible, Gaurav?
Yes, sir.
So this question is for Madhumita, roll number 225. Madhumita, are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
You only tell me these ligaments located with which bones? Is ligament ka jo positions hai, kis bone ke saath juda hua hai? ये दिख रहा है, लिखा हुआ भी है, सुपीरियर सेसामोइडियन लिगामेंट, जो कि यहाँ से चल रहा है और यहाँ आने के बाद दो भाग में बढ़ जाता है। तो आप बताएं कि ये जो लिगामेंट है किस बोन से जुड़ा हुआ है, बताएंगे? दिस क्वेश्चन सेम फॉर ईशा, 231, रोल नंबर 231। This ligament is attached with which bones? जवाब ना देने का क्या मतलब? या तो आपको समझ में नहीं आ रहा है, या पढ़ाते नहीं ढंग से।
मेटाकार्पल।
मेटाकार्पल। Good। इसलिए कि लिखा हुआ मेटाकार्पल। लेकिन हमारा जो हम पढ़ा रहे हैं, उसके अनुसार आंसर क्या होना चाहिए?
मेटाटार्सल।
मेटाटार्सल होना चाहिए। Exactly। Because the structure of the metacarpal, below that, the carpal joint ligaments are similar to that of the previous forelimb. So this is the metatarsal. So about the superior sesamoidian ligament, it originates from the proximal part of the metacarpal in case of the forelimb, and in case of the hind limb, originates from the proximal part of the metatarsal, runs downward in direction on its plantar surface. पीछे का भाग है ना, plantar surface, and divided into two parts, anterior and posterior. Okay, so anterior part comes in contact with this first phalanx, sorry, posterior part, and anterior parts comes on the distal part of the metatarsal and metacarpal. Okay, so this is the superior ligament. Two in number, one will goes anteriorly and another will come on its posterior part. Okay, you see about the superior sesamoidian ligament or suspensory ligament, also considered as the suspensory ligament or the musculus interosseus. It arises from the volar surface. In case of the metacarpal, this is the volar surface, or plantar surface in case of the hind limb, of the distal part of the tarsal bones, means proximal part of the metatarsal or metacarpal, and the proximal extremity of the large metatarsal descends on the volar surface in case of the forelimb, and plantar surface later on divided into the two branches, that is the anterior and posterior. We have already seen this, the structure of this one, this This originates from, this is the carpal in case of the forelimb, and will metacarpal, metatarsal, metatarsal in case of the hand. It originates from in between this joint, we can say the distal joint of the hock joint, and runs downward in direction on its volar surface or plantar surface, and reaches up to the first phalanx and divided into two parts. One is the anterior, another is the posterior part. So I think this is clear, Gaurav. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Sesamoidal ligament. Okay. Now, this is, yes, the intersesamoidal ligament. Intersesamoidal ligaments are the three in number. You see, this is the picture of the sesamoid bones. This is the picture of the sesamoid bone. There are four sesamoid bones. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have already seen in these pictures. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4. And in between this one, one will present here, another will present here, and another will present here. So how many total number will be, Nikhil Das, as per my descriptions, how many total number, Nikhil?
277.
Nikhil Das, unmute karega apne aapko. Nikhil Das, 227. गौरव इस रोल नंबर को याद रखना, 2277 will consider as absent. Next is for Vaibhav, 224. Vaibhav.
Yes sir.
Are you listening to me?
Yes sir. Yes, Nikhil Raj sir.
कहाँ थे निखिल जी?
सर यही थे सर.
क्यों नहीं आवाज दे रहे थे आप? जब मैं ऑप्शन का नाम लिया तो आपको आवाज आ गई उधर से. दिस इज फॉर निखिल. हाउ मेनी टोटल इंटरसिसामाइडियल बोन प्रेजेंट? अगर आप हमारे डिस्कशन को सुन रहे थे तो बताइए कितनी.
सर थ्री.
थ्री. तो क्यों नहीं जवाब दे रहे थे? मेरी आवाज अनम्यूट करेंगे अपने आपको भावेश. सो देयर आर थ्री इंटरसिसामाइडियल बोन्स आर प्रेजेंट, वन बिटवीन द lateral, or we can say abaxial, with the axial, another in between axial, and another with axial and abaxial. So there are three sesamoid bone present in between these in sesamoidian ligament, and this is considered as intersesamoidian ligament. This is considered as intersesamoidian. You see this slide here. So located between these four sesamoid bones, this is the sesamoid bone. Lateral we can say, or abaxial, and this is axial, and this is the axial, and this is abaxial sesamoid bone. So in between four, there are three sesamoid bones are present, that is called as intersesamoidian ligament, and it present between the four sesamoid bone. So you see here these sesamoid bone. This is visible. Ashutosh Kasyap, 259.
Yes, sir.
Morning, sir.
Yes, sir.
Cursor दिख रहा है आशुतोष?
Yes, sir.
ये बताओ ये गोल सा क्या दिख रहा है? ये जो गोल जैसा है वो अंडे की तरह ओवल स्ट्रक्चर? What is this?
Yes, sir.
क्या है?
Yes, sir. ये एक मिनट सर. ये सर प्रोक्सिमल या ये सिसमोइड है सर.
उसको पढ़ के तुम बता रहे हो.
सर बोन है. बोन है सर. बोन है सर.
कौन सा बोन है?
सिसमोइड बोन है सर.
कौन सा सिसमोइड बोन?
प्रोक्सिमल वाला.
प्रोक्सिमल वाला ठीक है. ये सिसमोइड बोन के बीच में कुछ धागा जैसा स्ट्रक्चर दिखाई दे रहा है. दिख रहा है दोनों को जोड़ने का कार्य. इसका क्या नाम सर? इसका क्या नाम जो कर
बोन बोन मोटू बोन है सर. लिगामेंट होगा सर.
कौन सा लिगामेंट होगा
सर? ये सर ये इंटर प्रोक्सिमल सेसमोइड लिगामेंट होगा सर. इंटर सेसमोइड लिगामेंट. इंटर सेसमोइड करके कुछ होगा.
ठीक है. इसकी
नाम से
इसकी संख्याएं कितनी होनी चाहिए? हाउ मेनी टोटल नंबर आर प्रेजेंट?
तीन लिगामेंट का तीन होना चाहिए. सॉरी पांच होना चाहिए. अब बोन सर चार होगा सर.
पांच कैसे हो जाएगा?
इंटर सर ओ सॉरी सर वो नहीं बीच वाला सर तीन ही हुआ. तीन ही होगा. वो हम साइड वाला भी जोड़ दिए थे. हमको लगा उधर भी ना कोई बोन होगा.
इसका मतलब तुम हमसे पहले बता रहे थे कि देयर आर थ्री इन नंबर, और यहाँ लिख करके भी हम बताए कि यू सी इन दिस स्लाइड this SL, this is sesamoidal ligament, intersesamoidal ligament.
सर वो इंटर सिसामोइडियल तीन होगा और वहां पे लिगामेंट सर पांच हो जाएगा ना, क्योंकि वो जो लास्ट वाला है उसको भी ना कोई बोन से उसको कनेक्ट करेगा, तो भी लिगामेंटेन होगा।
लिगामेंटेन होगा तो लिगामेंटम का चर्चा हम कर चुके पहले, क्या बताया था, लेटरल कोलेटरल बताए थे।
हाँ हाँ वही हो गया सर, वही हो गया,
नाम नहीं बोले थे, एक्जियल बोले थे, अब एक्जियल बोले थे। तो जो
सर वही
रहा था, ये जो सुपीरियर सिसामोइडियल लिगामेंट हो गया, इसकी कहानी खत्म हुई। ये जो एबैक्सियल बता रहे थे, एक्सियल एंड एबैक्सियल, ये जो एबैक्सियल लिगामेंट है यही लेटरल लेटरल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द लार्ज मेटाटार्सल अलोंग विद द एबैक्सियल सिसामोइडियल बोन। आप जो ये बता रहे हो, दिस लिगामेंट इज कंसीडर एज कोलेटरल सिसामोइडियल लिगामेंट या एबैक्सियल लिगामेंट। ओके
सर, उसको भी जोड़ दिए थे, बाद बाकी तीन होगा, इंटर वाला तो तीन होगा,
इसलिए नाम इंटर डाल रहे हैं ना, नाम इंटर नहीं डालते तो पांच हो सकता था। सो देयर आर थ्री, अनम्यूट करेगा, देयर आर थ्री इंटरसिसामोइडियल लिगामेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड एज पर द पिक्चर दिस इज क्लियर लोकेटेड इन बिटवीन फोर सिसामोइड बोन, दैट वाज द प्रोक्सिमल सिसामोइड बोन। ओके नाउ इज द कोलेटरल सिसामोइड, बिकॉज टोटल नंबर आर देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ द सिसामोइडियल लिगामेंट बट नंबर इज 11, सो दिस इज कोलेट्रल सिसामोइडियल। तो जो हम डिस्कशन कर रहे थे अभी इस पिक्चर्स में, ये जो है दिस इज द कोलेट्रल सिसामोइडियल लिगामेंट एंड हेयर विल आल्सो कोलेट्रल सिसामोइडियल लिगामेंट विल प्रेजेंट। सो टू इन नंबर, वन इज लोकेटेड ऑन लेटरल साइड, अनदर विल लोकेटेड ऑन द मीडियल साइड, वन इज लोकेटेड लेटरल साइड, अनदर इज लोकेटेड मीडियल साइड। नाउ क्वेश्चन इज दैट from your side, sir, you have already mentioned there should not be used lateral and medial. But this lateral and medial is not used for the these three phalanges in respect of their center positions. But this ligament is located in between two bones. That is the hand limb. One is the right, another the left. And their positions are on its the lateral aspect, and this is the lateral aspect, and in between two bones that will be the medial. So this ligament is considered as the collateral ligament, and this collateral ligament lateral medial. Okay. So if anybody asks you the position of collateral sesamoidal ligament, so answer will be collateral sesamoidal ligament two in number, one will be the lateral, another is the medial aspect, and which runs in between. Because name indicate sesamoidian ligament means involvement of the sesamoid bone, must be involvement of the sesamoid bone. So it located in between, this is the first phalange, this is the metatarsal, and this is the sesamoid bone. So the position of this collateral and lateral sesamoidian ligament on the lateral aspects in between distal part of the metatarsals, sesamoid bones, and the proximal part of the first phalanx. So this is the position of the lateral and behind and opposite to this, the medial collateral sesamoidal ligament. So I think this is clear. Saurav, Gaurav, is this clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Now is the inferior or distal, four in number, crossing in manner, two located down superficially and two located deeply. So these are four in number, and on the basis of their positions and locations, two are superficial located and two are deep seated located. And these are located between the distal extremity of metatarsal and tubercle of the proximal extremity of first phalanx. So you see here, name indicate the last ligament is the inferior or distal sesamoidal ligament, and they are located in the crossing manner. You see, these are the four in number, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Out of four, the position of two ligament is on anterior part towards the superficially located. So this is considered as superior, and this one is considered as also superior, and behind that which forms the crossing manner of this ligament, this is considered as the deep seated ligament. So there are the four distal or inferior sesamoid ligament present in the crossing manner which connects the abaxial sesamoid bones to the proximal part of the first phalanx on its the medial aspect, means axial aspect, and it's come from the abaxial aspect. And reverse that, one originates from the axial aspect and reaches up to the abaxial aspect of the first phalanx proximally. So I think this is also clear. Gaurav, this is clear about the inferior or the distal sesamoidal ligament. So
sir, एक बार फिर से बता दीजिए
किस कौन सा ज्वाइंट कौन सा लिगामेंट
वही सर वो सुपरफिशियल और डीप जो कहां से ओरिजिनेट हो रहा है समझ में नहीं
पिक्चर यू सी दिस पिक्चर इन दिस पिक्चर दिस इज विजिबल क्रॉसिंग माइनर फोर आर नंबर दिख रहा है
यस सर
है ना इसमें कह रहा है कि इसमें जो क्रॉसिंग माइनर हो रहा है तो टोटल संख्याएं चार दिख रहा है एक दो तीन चार इन चार में से जो आगे की तरफ रहेगा मतलब मेटाकार्पल या मेटाटार्सल से आगे की तरफ जो क्रॉसिंग मैनर बनाएगा जिसकी उत्पत्ति होगी ये अबैक्सियल पार्ट से और फर्स्ट फैलिंग्स के प्रोक्सिमल पार्ट में एक्सियल पार्ट में आएगा वो एंटीरियर कहलाएगा सुपरफिशियल कहलाएगा ओके जस्ट जिसकी उत्पत्ति ओरिजिनेशन होगा ये एक्सियल सिसामाइड बोन्स के नीचे से और वो अबैक्सियल पार्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट फैलिंग्स को आएगा उसको हम लोग पीछे की तरफ होगा इससे नीचे की तरफ होगा इसीलिए उसको हम लोग बोलेंगे डीप सीटेड लिगामेंट दैट इज द लोकेटेड ऑन इट्स इंफीरियर पार्ट ऑफ दिस ज्वाइंट सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द डिस्टल सिसामाइडियल लिगामेंट तो ये दोनों क्लियर हो गया कि जो आगे की तरफ रहेगा सर उसको हम लोग सुपीरियर कहेंगे तो ये जो क्रॉसिंग मैनर बन रहा है उसमें से एक आगे की तरफ दूसरा पीछे की तरफ इसमें भी एक आगे की तरफ और दूसरा पीछे की तरफ आई थिंक दिस इज क्लियर गौरव
यस सर
सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड वन इंपॉर्टेंट ज्वाइंट दिस इज द फेटलॉक ज्वाइंट एंड दिस इज द अनदर पिक्चर आई थिंक दिस इज नॉट क्लियरेबल रिटन पार्ट इज विजिबल बट दिस इज सेम इन प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ द ऑक्स सो व्हाट ज्वाइंट शुड बी ये कौन सा ज्वाइंट होना चाहिए कोई बताएगा एनीवन